So you can see my screen, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So a small correction. My name is Nikos Tzolas. I work in BETA CAE Systems. And today I will talk to you about how you can perform DOE studies in occupant protection using BETA CAE tools. So, as you all know, occupant safety is one of the most important tests during the design process of a vehicle. There are many regulations about occupant safety, but in order to make your cars to make the car safer, the cars are tested in many different crash scenarios. So, as you can understand, in order to test all these different crash scenarios, simulations are mandatory. In each different scenario, the parameters that affect the occupant injury results are different. And the best way to identify which parameters affect the occupant injury results in these scenarios is to perform design of experiments, DOE studies. So since DOE studies are used more and more, setting up easily DOE is very important. So in this presentation, we will see a setup of a DOE study, and this DOE will study how occupant injuries are affected from different seatbelt parameters. We will use a front impact sled test with Thor 50M dummy on a rigid seat. And the parameters that we will test, that we will check, is the shoulder slipring height, the chest belt routing path, and the friction between the belt and the dummy. So, before setting up the DOE, we have to set up the sled test. We will do it in ANSA, the preprocessor of BETA CAE system. And we will start by positioning the seat. There is a seat positioning tool in ANSA. You can position the seat either regulation based, so you can select one of the available regulations, and with this wizard, ANSA will help you to position the seat exactly like the protocol requires, or you can make your own movements. You can have a user-defined seat positioning, or you can get laboratory data, map them on the kinematic mechanism of the seat, and then position the seat the same position that you had it in the actual crash test. The tool can save, can create and save several different positions. And since we are talking about DOE studies, imagine that this could be one of your design variables. And in each experiment, you could change you could use a different seat position. These positions can be output in star node and star node transformation keyword files. So the seat can be treated as a read-only file, and you can position it just by reading these keyword files. The whole procedure is can be automated using Python scripts. After positioning the seat, the next thing is to put the dummy, position it onto the seat. Here, we will, for this, we will use the dummy articulation tool of ANSA. It supports all dummies, all the ATDs in the market, and it offers an easy articulation of the different bodies of the dummy by respecting and previewing hard or soft angles. So this is done through the joint stiffness keyword or from the hierarchy of the dummy. It respects the contact between the bodies of the dummy in order not to have self-penetrations in the dummy. And the tool also respects the contact between the dummy and the surrounding parts in order not to have penetration between the dummy and the car. In case you have self-penetrations in the dummy while trying to position it, but ANSA can set up the marionette method in order for LS Dyna to make the positioning of the dummy without having any penetrations. Small self-penetrations in the dummy can be also solved within ANSA without the need of running a simulation. Again, this tool can can create many different positions and save them. And again, these positions can be used in a DOE study. And these positions are output as star node and star node transform keywords. So the dummy again can be used, can be treated as a read-only file. After positioning the dummy on the seat, we have to be sure that we have a penetration-free dummy seat system. In case there are penetrations between the dummy and the seat, between the dummy and the cushion, ANSA can deform the cushion geometrically. No need for solution here. And in case we cannot fix all the penetrations with this functionality, then you can set up a pre-crash simulation inside ANSA, and LS Dyna will do the job and will depenetrate the dummy from the cushion. After positioning the dummy, the next thing is to create the seat belt and restrain the dummy on the seat. The seat belt tool of ANSA will be used for this. It offers an easy and fast definition of an optimized seat belt shape. This is a template driven. Procedure is template driven, so you can reapply this also in no GUI mode. All the necessary LS Dyna keywords are created. And in case you want to improve the shape of the dummy, as you can see in the video that plays now, you can interactive edit the shape of the seatbelt. One more thing that you can do in order to have a better seatbelt shape is to apply tension on the seatbelt. You can apply a force, and the multi-body dynamic solver of LS Dyna will stretch the seatbelt, as you can see now in the video. You will get this stretching in real time inside ANSA, so you can achieve a better seatbelt shape. All this procedure again can be automated through Python scripts. So after creating the setting up the sled test, we can set up the design variables that will be used in our DOE. The first design variable is the slipper, the shoulder slipping height. Using direct morphing, we'll move the slipring along the Z axis. As you can see here, we used four different, five different, sorry, positions for the slipping, and morphing parameter was created, and this parameter will be changed later in during the DOE creation in order to create the different experiments. The second design variable is the seatbelt, the chest seatbelt routing path, and for its seatbelt, for its shoulder slipping height, four different paths will be created, will be used, and this is done through a Python script that runs from the seatbelt tool of ANSA. And finally, the last design variable is the friction between the seatbelt and the dummy. So for this, an A parameter will be created in order to modify the friction keywords in the contact between the dummy and the seatbelt. So the design variables are created, and the next step is to set up the DOE. ANSA and META can be connected with optimizers like LSOPT. LSOPT could do this job, but this is also possible inside ANSA in the optimization tool of ANSA. Here, the most important thing is to create the optimization task, a procedure that an automatic procedure that will change the morphing parameter for the shoulder slipping height, the A parameter for the friction in the contact. It will run the script items for the seatbelt creation and reapplication, and finally it will do the LSDyna keyword output, and it will submit LSDyna. So this task is created in ANSA in the optimization tool, and from the DOE setup tab of this tool, this task will run in order to create all the experiments. After submitting LSDyna to solve the and get the results, META will be used to extract the responses and the histories. And the definition of the responses and the histories will be done again inside META. So in order to do this, we have to run a base run of our model, of our test, and then inside the in META extract the occupant injury results automatically with the help of the occupant injury criteria tool. And after extracting the results, this tool offers the capability to select easily which results will be used as responses and histories. So you will have a list with all the created results, and you will be able to select which value of each result you want to use as a response, if it will be the max or the minimum or the absolute maximum of this result or both, and if these results will be used, will be output as histories and so on. You can also set up a time range and calculate the results in this time range and export them as responses. So after selecting the results you need, you will output a configuration file in which the responses are stated, which values will be used as responses, and you will output a session file with commands that includes commands in META, which will automatically extract the same results as responses for our DOE. So after defining the responses, we go back to the optimization tool, and in the DOE setup tab, as I said earlier, you can set up the DOE. The available DOE algorithms here are the full factorial, the uniform Latin hypercube, random algorithm, the Taguchi orthogonal arrays, and the linear algorithm. And in our case, we used the full factorial. We wanted to check all the possibilities, all the combinations between our design variables, how they affect the results. And here in the list, you can have a preview of all the experiments that are created and the variables, the design variables that are used in each experiment. Then the tool will produce all the needed LS-DYNA keyword files. There were around there were 100 experiments in our case, and this is done quite fast. You will have one folder for each experiment, and in each folder you will have the keyword files, the LS-DYNA keyword file that is needed for the solution. The tool will also generate a script that will submit LS-DYNA and META after LS-DYNA for all these experiments in order to get the results. So we created the DOE, we output all the keyword files, we run this in LS-DYNA, we got the results, and let's go to see how you can evaluate the results. First, we can have an evaluation of responses, an overview of all the responses inside the optimization tool of ANSA, again in the same environment. So you can have, as earlier, a list with experiments, the design variables for each experiment, and now you can see also the response values. You can see the response values as point charts. So you can see here the left shoulder result and force responses, how they change over shoulder slipping position here at the top, and over seatbelt position, over the chest seatbelt routing path here at the bottom. And apart from point charts, you can have line charts. So in this example, you can see how the thoracic spine next force changes over the experiment IDs. And by selecting a point, you can see the design variables that were used for this experiment. The evaluation of the histories is done inside META with the help of the occupant injury criteria tool again. So you can see here all the histories of all the experiments. You can see the thoracic spine force and moment results. We see that we didn't get big variation results for the thoracic spine at least. And since we used the shoulder slipping height as one of our design variables, let's check the the shoulder results, the left and right inboard clavicle forces. Here we see a bigger variation of results. And let's focus on the resultant forces for the left and right shoulder. Indeed, the variation, the differences are bigger here. You see all the experiments with gray color, and the envelope curves are the red and the blue, showing the max and mean results. And we notice that we have some peaks and some differences, some bigger differences after 85 milliseconds of the simulations. In order to answer to this question, why we have these peaks, it's not easy to answer to this question just by looking the curves. So in order to answer, we will have to check the 3D results. And the big advantage of making the histories evaluation inside META is that you can see at the same time the history results and the 3D results of the experiments. The tool offers the capability to select a specific experiment and load its 3D results and see the results side by side, like here. So in our sled test, we didn't use an airbag. So at some point after 85 milliseconds, the head comes in contact with the chest. And most probably, this is the reason why we have these differences and these peaks towards the end of the simulation. So you can understand that the capability to evaluate 3D deformations along with the responses and histories is quite important. We checked, after checking all the results, we found out that the bigger differences, the bigger variation was in the thorax rib deflections. Here you see the resultant deflection of the upper left and upper right thorax ribs. So you can see them at the top left and top right windows here. And similarly to the bottom, you see the lower left and the lower right thorax rib deflections. We see that the bigger variation exists in the upper left thorax rib, also to the lower right, and then also to the upper right. The lower left rib was not affected so much. Let's see now how each design variable affected our results. We see here four different experiments that have the same slipping height, the same friction between the dummy and the seatbelt, but different chest belt routing path. We see the 3D results, and you can have an animation of the results. And here we see the histories. You can understand the relation between the histories and the 3D results from the color of the curves and the belts. So this design variable, the chest belt routing path, affected a lot the upper left thorax rib. It didn't affect the upper right. It affected a little bit. It affected also the lower right. And for the lower left, we have the differences mostly towards the end of the simulation. The next design variable is the that we check is the friction between the dummy and the belt. So here we see three different experiments with the same slipring height, the same chest build routing path and different friction. Again, the upper left thorax rib results, the deflection results were affected from the difference in friction between the dummy and the seatbelt. The upper right is not affected. The lower right again is affected, and also the lower left, but mostly towards the end of the simulation. And the last design variable that we used is the different shoulder slipring height. So here we have five experiments with the same chest belt routing, the same friction between the dummy and the belt, and different shoulder slipping height, different shoulder slipping heights. We see at the top here the histories. Let's focus on the results. So we see now all the experiments, so the 3D results, one on top of the other. So for this design variable, we see that we don't that we see that this design variable does not affect or did not affect a lot our results. So let's conclude and summarize what we saw in this presentation. The fact from the beginning was that the DOEs are state of the art in identifying the parameters that affect the results, from changing different parameters. We saw this also in this presentation. We found out that the shoulder slipping height does not affect a lot. Small changes in the height of the slipping does not affect a lot the results, at least the thorax rib deflections, while the friction between the seatbelt and the dummy and the path from where the belt passes on the chest affect the occupant injury results more. And setting up and since DOEs are used more and more, setting up a DOE easily is important. And in ANSA, you can perform a complete occupant safety analysis. You can set up the analysis, and you can set up the DOE easily in the same environment. And since you do this in the same software, it doesn't add complexity in your work, and it is time and cost effective. And you can also have an evaluation of the responses in the same environment in the optimization tool of ANSA. So again, you don't add more complexity in your work. We saw that main ANSA functionality can be combined with customized sub-processes, Python scripts. So you can set up more complicated DOEs. In our example, the seatbelt, the chest seatbelt routing path, the different paths were created through a Python script. We saw that META automatically extracts occupant injury results, and the definition and the extraction of histories and responses is an easy process. You just have a list and you select which results you want to output as responses, and the tool will automatically create a session that can be used from optimizers in order to extract the results. And finally, we saw that evaluating 3D deformations along with responses and histories is very important in order to understand the results better. So that was all I had to show to you today. If you have any questions, please ask. Do not hesitate.
Okay, I will close the session. I will post a link to the evaluation form, so please fill out the evaluation form. Just take your time. It's 2 minutes, it's really short, but helps us to improve our service. With that being said, I'm going to close the session. And thank you again for the talk.
And thank you, Zoo.
Yeah, see you next week. Yeah.
Goodbye, everybody.